cutaneous diphtheria is caused by Carinebacterium diphtheriae, a pleomorphic, aerobic, gram-positive bacillus that causes symptoms through the production of a bacteriophage-dependent exotoxin. Human beings are the only known reservoir for C. diphtheriae, which can only inhabit mucous membranes and skin and is therefore spread by respiratory droplets or contact with the exudate of a diphtheritic cutaneous lesion, including objects contaminated with discharge from the lesion. There are three forms of cutaneous diphtheria. Primary infection, which begins as a pustule or a vesicle on previously normal skin. Superinfection of an eczematized lesion. Secondary infection of a wound. Cutaneous diphtheria typically follows an indolent course, usually remaining local, with few known cases of toxic complications, cardiomyopathy or neuropathy, as seen more frequently with upper respiratory tract diphtheritic infections. However, cutaneous infection is associated with more bacterial shedding and higher rates of transmission of pharyngeal and cutaneous diphtheria to close contacts. The skin is often an importation reservoir for C. diphtheriae and is associated with sporadic cases of respiratory diphtheria, therefore, prompt recognition and treatment of cutaneous diphtheritic infection may reduce environment contamination with C. diphtheriae. Those at greatest risk for cutaneous diphtheria are people living in impoverished, crowded, unhygienic environments, particularly in the developing world, or immigrants from countries where rates of vaccination with diphtheria toxoid are low. Southeast Asia is a known endemic area, and the disease has been associated with the tropics, although it exists in temperate regions as well. There has been a shift in the age demographics of cases occurring in the U.S. In the pre-vaccination era, it was typically a pediatric problem. Now it is more common in those aged over 15, since this population is less likely to have had the vaccination or adequate boosters. Cutaneous diphtheria. Isabelle Wilson, MB, BS, D.T.M.H., and S.E.N. Menson, MB, CH.B, D.Phil. A 5-year-old. Fully vaccinated girl was brought to the emergency department with pruritic lesions on both legs. She had recently returned from a trip to Sierra Leone. The lesions had appeared 3 weeks into her stay there and had increased in size and ulcerated. On presentation, she was afebrile, and an area over the medial aspect of the left lower leg was ulcerated and bleeding, banally. The C-reactive protein level was mildly elevated, and the white cell count was normal. Empirical treatment with oral floxacillin was initiated, and a skin swab was sent for culture, which grew Staphylococcus aureus, group A streptococcus, and Carinebacterium diphtheriae. Gram staining showed predominantly gram-positive bacilli characteristic of Carinebacterium, panel B. An immunodiffusion test, LX test, was positive, indicating that this diphtheria was toxin-producing. Early manifestations of cutaneous diphtheria can appear as non-healing, well-demarcated ulcers. After the detection of diphtheria in this patient, the antibiotic agent was changed to clarithromycin. Contact tracing was undertaken, and chemoprophylaxis was given to household contacts. At follow-up 1 week after the change in antibiotics to clarithromycin, the skin lesions had fully healed. Isabelle Wilson, MB, BS, D.T.M.H. S.E.N. Menson, MB, CH.B, D.Phil. Evelina London Children's Hospital, London, United Kingdom. NEJM, Medicine by Alexandros G. Sfakianakis.